Smother this guy and get close. But the punch is still Pacquiao.
Hard left hand by Pacquiao. Stunned Hatton and knocked him back. Look at the brilliant accuracy of Manny Pacquiao. Landing with both right and left hands. And then he closed down Pacquiao's left side. Hard right hand again by Pacquiao.
Over past the zoo.
Pacquiao's blinding speed that sets him apart.
Ability to punch, maintain balance, which he used to couldn't do. And his head
and allowed himself to get a little wild. Now he goes back to more precision.
That is.
Oh my gosh, what a straight left hand. And will Hatton make it up from this?
Can he beat the count?
Is that it? And Kenny Bella says, no way. That is that. What an amazing knockout shot. That is the most spectacular one-punch shot of Manny Pacquiao's incredible career.
Any fighter.
Take a look at this. Take a look at this.
This is a perfect time.
That was super slow motion.
Yeah, and he never saw it.
He was unconscious from the moment he caught that shot. Goes to the canvas in the proverbial heap.
And there's the speed advantage for Pacquiao. Cotto will keep going there anyway. Good left hook by Miguel Cotto.
Cotto just physically a bigger guy.
Now Pacquiao starting to. He's going to punch so far. And he's going to see if Pacquiao can take his stuff. Pacquiao hits Cotto with a hard left hand. And another. But Cotto can take the punch. He's not being knocked back. Good body shot by Cotto.
I'm being slugging with him.
Plus the footwork gets him into position to land.
He bounces off his touch. Very good.
Was rushing in. Manny landed a little right hook in there. Follows up by knocking Cotto. Pacquiao beating Cotto to the punch now. No blood. Three hard body shots for stop throwing. Cotto lands his jab. Now, when Pacquiao throws, Cotto goes into a little shell because of all the speed he sees.
That's Manny's rhythm to go in and out and punch on his
left toes. Hook countered by Cotto landed.
We've seen Cotto in these situations before, and he comes back. Pacquiao getting hit in recent fights.
Uppercut snaps Pacquiao's head back. Remember.
Great reflexes and timing. Where you can see his little openings that very few fighters can see. That's why he lives a lot.
But he landed it a few times.
Because he can hurt you with punches and not even stand up punches.
And when Cotto...
Tactical retreat.
Absolutely. Just as he was in the late rounds against Margarito. Decision to just box is yielding better results than the earlier firefight. But now Pacquiao's backing him off again. Got him against the ropes. Tries to end it with one big left. Cotto backs into the corner. He's in big trouble now. The fight could end in a matter of seconds. Holding on.
He can't hold his ground. He can't see the punches coming.
Trying to counter. Reddy's been pretty good at this.
Fight me. He said Pacquiao would still win.
And Pacquiao is going to go in for the kill now.
Pacquiao is looking for KO 11 right here. Cotto still fighting.
Cloudy at the end of the fight.
Sure.
You have to doubt he'll ever be great again.
And Miguel Cotto's father, Miguel Cotto Sr., wanted to stop the fight and was talked out of it by the others in the corner, including head trainer Joe Santiago. Now Kenny Bayless does his duty.
Now flirts with the corner there, then moves away. Now his back is against the ropes. Margarito tries to press the axe, and Pacquiao hits a bluff with a big left hand, and then flurries. Marks begin to show on Margarito's face as he has a big red welt under his right eye. So Pacquiao can do that.
Yeah, Margarito's saying that Pacquiao's not hurting him, but his face is telling a different story.
Indeed. And Pacquiao's beginning to land with almost every punch. Pacquiao was a terrific, world-class, one-handed fighter. Margarito banging him against the ropes here, trying to get to Pacquiao's body to change the fight. Pacquiao fighting back with his back on the ropes.
And here comes
Manny. And he turns it around and bangs Margarito viciously on the bad eye. And another one. Hits him again with the left. Margarito nods at him. Pacquiao hits him at will. Bang.
That's his biggest factor, is fighting while he's tired.
And he's blocking some of the punches, taking some. He took a big left hook. To draw your own conclusions.
I talked to Miguel earlier today. Miguel said this was going to be a very tough fight. Because I was telling him, I thought that Pacquiao had to edge. He said, man, he may have edge, but it's going to be a hard fight. Punches a little better than a smaller guy. But a regular 140-pounder, I think Manny would have knocked out.
At this point.
Unless somebody wants to stop the fight because of that right eye, which is grotesque.
Pacquiao do what he does better than any boxer in the game. Let a guy miss, catch him with a punch, let him miss, hit him with a punch again. A lot of guys will let guys miss punches, but they don't take advantage of it the way that he does.
Freddie Roach wanted to get the Texas State Athletic Commission to make Margarito shave off the beard, which probably they would have done. Pacquiao said, leave it there. I want to use it as a target. That's a fighter. Greatest offensive fighter of the era.
Physically fatigued, both. And this right hook.
He's ready to go.
That's one of the biggest jabs.
He didn't see it coming.
That was a right hook from Pacquiao. Yeah. Another measure of redemption for Margarito. Even though he's the villain with the hand wraps, hopelessly behind and getting
no hand movement at all.
Pacquiao looking towards the ref, asking him to stop the fight at this point, it looks to me. Landed a shot, looked towards.
He's out being outpunched, but the referee has to wait a few more seconds before the
stop. Emmanuel, he's rearranging Margarito's face.
If the referee stopped, it wouldn't be any complaint, but I just don't think he's going to stop at the tables. It's a solid target. He's not moving his head.
I honestly wonder whether Pacquiao has no more stomach for the punishment.
Then he took the fight.
Hard to say because he's fighting such different guys
every
time out, and they're all so big. And we're done.
Jim, your prediction was right.